Coming to the advantages and disadvantages of the wet thermal method. First, we will see the advantages. It is environmentally sound process, low investment and very low operational cost. It is very easy. You just have to collect the waste and to pour a chemical disinfectant, the wet method, and your job is done. After some time, automatically disinfection will take place. So it is low cost, low tech method. Disadvantages: shredders will undergo frequent breakdown, which leads to poor functioning of the wet thermal process. Requires qualified persons to maintain that shredder, and inadequate for anatomical, pharmaceutical and chemical waste, as they are not permeable to the heat. Coming to the next method, that is microwave irradiation. Microwave irradiation, as you all know, we use in our households for cooking food. The frequency that is used for disinfection is 2450 megahertz. Infectious agents are destroyed by heat conduction, so they are heated and thus killed. Efficiency has to be checked for virological and bacteriological tests repeatedly. So you have to keep an eye on the efficiency of microwave irradiation, and of course it is costly. Advantages of microwave irradiation are: it has got good disinfection efficacy, it decreases the waste volume greatly, and it is environmentally sound. The disadvantages are operational and maintenance problems. Since again it is a high-tech equipment, the maintenance and operational component of the microwaves would be high and can lead to problems. Land disposal, or good old land with disposal methods. Municipal disposal sites can be used. Open dumps are not preferred. We saw for general waste also, the same holds true for hospital waste and even serious. It is much serious for hospital waste. You can have sanitary landfills after we have incinerated. We saw the ash that is left after incineration is basically like other household waste and therefore can be put into a sanitary landfill. Sanitary landfills causes geographic isolation, which means you do not have direct access to the waste. Procedure: what is to be done is appropriate engineering preparation for the site at which the dumping is to be done should be there, so that the chemicals and other infectious agents do not leach out again back to the surrounding. Staff should be present on the site to control the operation. It should be a organized deposit so that everything is managed well and you don't spread the litter outside, and daily coverage of waste. That is then called a sanitary landfill. If you just dump it, then it is dumping. Sanitary landfill, you have to cover the waste so that it is not accessible to dogs, insects and other animals. Coming to inertization, it is basically mixing waste with cement, forming blocks, and thus we prevent the waste from leaching out into the atmosphere. So what we do, we take cement, we take the biomedical waste, we mix it, we put some water, we make some concrete blocks, basically construction business, and then what you have is a big cement block. The advantage, those wastes are tapped inside and they won't leach back. So mixing waste with cement or substances before disposal in order to minimize the risk of toxic substance contaminating the water is this. A homogeneous mass of cubes and pellets are formed. Depends upon what you want. If you want to build a house, maybe you can make bricks. So it is essentially locking the substance inside, and it is transported to suitable storage site. What are the proportions for materials which are inertized? It is 65% pharmaceutical waste, 15% of lime, 15% cement and 5% water. So typically it is used for pharmaceutical waste, and you can see the proportion is pretty high. So it is good. I can use a lot of pharmaceutical waste and I can treat it very effectively with minimal other investments. Advantages: it is inexpensive. And disadvantages are: it is not for infectious waste. Infectious waste would again leach out, and the cement won't be a very good idea to hold back infectious waste. Now we finish off with the descriptive part. We start off with the difficult part. From here onwards, what you have is just hard facts which are supposed to be remembered, and you have to mug up the category to which the waste belong, which plastic to dump the waste, and what is then done with the plastic. Let us start. This is something which is really taxing on the memory. I understand that. So I'll give you important points in the last table so that you know what to focus on. Color code red. Red color code, you have the following waste to be put into it. Microbiology and biotechnology waste. Ignore these numbers just for now. This 367, we'll come to that. This is a category of waste which is to be put here. Solid waste and solid waste which are disposables are to be put in the color code red, and the treatment to be given to this is autoclaving or microwaving or chemical treatment. The second slide is color code yellow. First is human anatomical waste, anatomical waste for animals, microbiology and biotechnology waste, solid waste such as dressings, casts, beddings which are contaminated with blood, everything is put into yellow. So yellow is infectious. Something which is infectious, yellow. Blood, infection, organ, tissue in the yellow bag. Treatment, incineration or burial. Color code is blue or white or translucent. You have sharps and solid waste without blood contamination. So those can be put in the blue. Treatment is autoclaving or microwaving, chemical treatment or shredding. Color code black. Discarded medicines and cytotoxic drugs and incineration ash. Item number 10, that is category number 10, solid chemicals are also put in black. So anything that is powdery is put into black. Treatment is by disposal in secured landfill. Now coming to the important table in front of you. What you see on the left hand side is the category of the waste. What you see in the middle is the waste category's name, and on the right hand side what you have is the treatment and disposal of the waste. So you have these categories 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 10, and you have waste which are classified into those 10 categories. This table can be taxing. A couple of questions appear, they may also not appear. So it is your call to invest your time and memory into it, because sometimes questions have been asked on this, but it is a lot of things to remember simultaneously. Category number 1 is human anatomical waste to be treated by incineration and deep burial. Category number 2 for anatomical waste, incineration and deep burial again for animal waste. Category number 3, microbiological and biotechnology waste for sent for local autoclaving, microwaving or incineration. Category number 4 was waste sharps, and that is put for chemical disinfection, autoclaving or microwaving. Fifth is discarded medicines, cytotoxic drugs, medication and shredding. Sixth is solid waste, plasters are sent for incineration, destruction and land disposal. Seventh category is solid waste, and it is again sent for incineration and autoclaving. Eighth is liquid waste, sent for chemical treatment. Ninth, incineration ash for municipal landfills. And 10th is chemicals sent to chemical treatment and drains. What to do with these bags we just collected? So if you have to remember, it would be a better thing to remember this table rather than remembering the big table. Also, what you need to know is how to classify the waste. So if you know what goes into the red, yellow, blue bag and the black bag, then you can directly come to this last slide which is showing on your screens right now, and you can decide what has to be done about it. This table is very big and is very difficult to remember. So in order to optimize your memorization, let us remember what bag contains what and directly what has to be done with that bag. Coming to the second important table then, yellow plastic bag, category 1, 2, 3 and 4 wastes are to be put into it, and treatment options are incineration and deep burial. Red bag, the type of container is disinfected container or a plastic bag. Category 3, 6 and 7 goes into it. You do autoclaving, microwaving or chemical treatment. Blue, white or translucent bag, you have to have a plastic bag or a puncture proof container. Why? Because if you remember, this bag had the sharps, So therefore you can have puncture in the plastic bag, and therefore you will have to have a puncture proof container. Something you should know, because this is, if I have to frame a question, this is something which is different. So blue or white bag should be puncture proof, otherwise the shafts will puncture through it and spill out. Category 4 and 7 goes into the blue bag, and it is treated by autoclaving, microwaving or chemical treatment. Black bag can be a plastic bag. We saw that basically dust, powders, kind of things go into a black bag. Category 5, 9 and 10, all are solids and they are disposed of in a landfill. So you want to remember something, remember what goes into what plastic bag, and directly this table, what has to be done with what plastic bag. So you have your work cut out. Then the next slide shows you biomedical waste management in India. This is some India specific knowledge. Again, because you are going to give examinations in India, MCI screening tests, post graduation examinations, various states, so therefore it is important to know what happens in India. After all said and done, what we discussed right now was common to the whole wide world. So some India specific facts and figures. Biomedical waste management and handling rule is there in India, which was formulated in 1998. Again, don't remember the year. Ministry of Environment and Forest, Government of India, is in charge for this act. It tells you about the generation, collection, reception, storage, disposal and treatment of biomedical waste. So basically everything, anything and everything that has to do with biochemical waste is handed to the Biomedical Waste Act. The United Nations Conference on Environment and Development recommended the following measures. MCQ can be framed on this, because these are some specific things. Prevent and minimize waste production. Reuse or recycle the waste to the extent possible. Treat waste by safe and environmentally sound methods, and dispose of the final residue by landfill in confined and carefully designed sites. So the analogy which you have, reuse, recycle, that is the same thing. Reuse and recycle. Whatever possible, reuse or otherwise recycle. So that is the crux of the UNCED recommendations. With that, we conclude the chapter of hospital waste management. See you in the next class.